Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's take a look at using memories in the Mac Photos app. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign. Join us and get exclusive content and course discounts. So in the Mac Photos app, on the left, you have an item here called Memories. You also may get notifications from time to time that there's a new memory to check out. So what are memories? Well, they are just collections of photos that are grouped together using the Photos app's artificial intelligence features. So it's basically looking for groups of photos that were taken at the same time, at the same place, or perhaps with the same person, or perhaps of the same person, or there's some other thing linking those photos together. It will often find groups of photos that were exactly a year or two or three before, or occasionally come up with other things, like photos of a particular person or maybe pets or certain objects. So for instance here, if I look in my sample photos library, I could see it recently created a new memory called Year in Review, which makes sense since it's the beginning of a new year. Now to view a memory, just double click it and you go into the memory, and at the top here you're going to see one big image, and it's basically going to play a silent slideshow for you here using kind of a Ken Burns effect to make things move around a bit. If you want this to go full screen, you can click this button here and now it'll take the memory into the full viewing area of photos. Once you're in here, you can move the cursor around and you see video playback controls here, though it's not really a video, it's playing a slideshow. So I could pause, I could change the volume on the music that's playing, I could also click here and change some things, like for instance the theme being used, which will affect the music and how the photos are displayed. Also, you often have short, medium, and long options here as to how many photos should be used in this video. Since there are only so many photos in this memory, only short and medium are available for this one. Now a lot of people ask if there's a way to export this slideshow here as a video. And the answer is no, there's not, at least not on the Mac. I'll talk more about that in a minute. Now underneath the slideshow at the top, you can scroll down and see a section called Photos. And this will arrange a bunch of photos here for you to be able to look at. And of course you can go to anyone you want by double clicking on that photo. And it goes into it just like you're reviewing it in an album or in your library. You can use the arrow here to go back. You can also click Show More and it will change to a grid view and show all the photos in the memory. Switch to Show Summary to go back to this view. Underneath this, you'll find people, and it's going to show you people that are included in this memory. So you may see more than one, and you can go into people view for that individual if you want. You also see places, and it'll show on a map the different locations that are used here. So then you see related, other memories and locations and albums that are related to this. Now at the bottom you'll see controls. You can add to favorite memories. Now this is important if you want to keep the memory around. It's not going to keep all of your memories around. It's just going to have a few that are there, and old ones are going to drop off the bottom as new ones are added to the top. So if there's a memory you really like, you want to add to favorites, and then you'll have this collection of favorites where this memory will stay there until you remove it. You can also delete this memory if you're done looking at it or you just don't want this memory to be around. You can also go to suggest fewer memories like this. So remember, this one was suggesting a kind of year in review. So if I say show less like this, then I'm probably not going to see a year in review next year. But there are other types of memories as well. For instance, here's one called Four-Legged Friends. And I'm bound to probably see this memory pop up from time to time, or maybe ones kind of related to it, showing animals and pets and things. So if I said show fewer like this, I may not see memories that involve animals in the future. Now you can also do other things with the share button here at the top. Notice it says share 16 photos. So it's not sharing the memory, it's just sharing the list of photos that's in the memory. So I can add it as a shared album, I can email them, AirDrop them, and do other things as well. I could also select the photos. So maybe use Show More to make sure I'm seeing all of them. Select the first one and then shift click to select the last one, and then do New Album with Selection. And now I've created a new album that's a separate thing from that memory. But if you really like the memory, you may decide you want to create an album to keep that group of photos around instead of leaving it as a memory. Now when you go to your list of memories, you have memories and favorite memories. And remember I said you could save a memory as a favorite memory. So when you click on that, you could see your favorite memory saved here. Remember to do that if you want to keep them around permanently. Now a lot of people want to take this slideshow and save it out as a video so they can share it with others or keep it around. And unfortunately there's no way to do that in Photos on the Mac. But if you're using iCloud, your Photos library is going to sync across your devices. And you actually can save the slideshow as a video if you're looking at it in iOS or iPadOS. On the Mac, though, it's easy to actually create a slideshow from Photos. So you could go to your Photos here. I'll use Show More so I can select all of these. And then I could do File and then Create and Slideshow and then choose Photos as the slideshow maker. And now I can create my own slideshow using those photos. And this will be very similar to the slideshow in Memories, but you have a lot more control because you have the full set of slideshow controls. And I showed this in many videos before. You can create captions. You could rearrange the order of the photos and set lots of different options for, say, the music and themes for the slideshow. And this kind of slideshow you can export as a video. In fact, another way to do that is here on the main memory screen. You can control click, right click on a mouse or two finger click on a trackpad. And you have a lot of options here, including to create and then a slideshow. So you can take just the images that were used in that actual slideshow and it'll create a new slideshow from that. So you can see here it was just using 16 out of those 20 images here in the slideshow. But this is still a different slideshow and you can go through and customize this before you export it. This is also how you remove a memory from favorites. You can do it here because this happens to be a memory saved in favorites. But if you go to favorites here, you can also remove it or delete the memory right here. There are a couple of things in Photos preferences related to memories. You have show holiday events, so you could turn that off and you won't get memories associated with holidays. You also have show memories notification. So if you turn that off, you won't get notifications anymore when a new memory is created. And you also have reset suggested memories. So this is when you click to suggest this type of memory less and you decide you've done that too much and you want to reset it, you can use this button to reset that and start over. So memories isn't a feature that you necessarily need to use. Matter of fact, I suspect most people don't use it. It's just simply another way to view your photos. You can view them in the library, you can create albums, you can view by people and places, and you can use memories to view your photos that way. Think of it like this. It's your own photo library suggesting to you groups of photos that you might enjoy looking at today. Compare that to other things like websites and social media that also demand your attention while using your computer. Viewing your own photos in Memories in the Photos app may actually be a better way to spend your time and a good way to get more enjoyment out of the photos that you've taken. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.